The complexities of feelings that I have when I paint is an aliveness that I just can't put into words. And I remember reading Henry Miller, and he split the world into the alive and dead. And painting, for me, is just total aliveness. It's a high beyond any high. Even when you feel overwhelmed with confusion, the inability to know what to do, just sheer desperation. It's palpable, it's physically painful even, but it just is such an acute, powerful feeling that it's thrilling, inspiring and thrilling. People often ask me, how did I know I was an artist? Because I didn't really even know what an artist was, yet I knew I was an artist. I think part of that is kind of youthful desperation of and a fantasy of what an artist is, what the power of art is. But going to see Van Gogh and going to the Museum of Modern Art when I was young, the experience of seeing these great paintings, many of them were just extraordinarily powerful in a way that was so totally unusual and different from the pedestrian life. It just made me feel just the beauty and power of art. You know, when you learn history as a child, none of it compares to seeing a Goya. Those paintings deeply affected me to just sort of feel that I also, if I dig deep enough, will come up with something powerful like that. I was very inspired by reading Carl Jung's autobiography, Memories, Dreams, and Reflections, and just realizing the power of archetypes. Just understanding that as I go, I'm connected. And so that inspiration of even wanting to be an artist comes from something that's beyond time and inexplainable. When I first became an artist, it was right after the Vietnam War ended. One of the realities was that I would have been drafted had it not been ended. I had a low number in the draft, and the sheer senselessness of being shipped all the way around the world to fight in a war that made absolutely no sense, that was horribly condemned by everybody that I thought was intelligent, was just completely frightening. It sort of made me feel that the only way out was art, that the only way to understand or make sense of this terribly confusing, violent world was to somehow make art. Whether it's true or not, art and the inspiration of creating it and the flow and the power of the flow that I feel made me feel completely infinite and invincible. If there's anything that, you know, one wants to feel, it's that. I think for me, the whole point of making art was to discover myself, to find meaning, to understand why I exist. As a child of Holocaust survivors, understanding my parents' experience of the world, life could seem quite meaningless. Even those that survived questioned their meaning. They weren't happy. They didn't find joy in life. So what you learn as a child is there has to be something more. The events of World War II pointed out to me that religion fails, that there is no justice, that there is no God, there is no adhering to the rule of God, and that you'll go to heaven. First off, finding ecstasy in art, finding meaning in art, even if that meaning is an illusion, finding inspiration, following some sort of language that's purely visual, that makes no verbal sense, that has no purpose, that is guided by your inner spirit. This actually excited me to such a point that it was self-fulfilling. It was inspiring all the way through. And I'm guided by it, I believe in it, and there's nothing else to believe in.
So there you have it.